Just looking at the ratings for some of the places around this street taco stand, this place is a 5-star in my book, one of the best places. You know what? What's always fascinated me is there's Yelp and so many other review sites all around the world where people are going and looking up street taco stands, burrito places, sushi places, the pizza they're gonna eat. People go and do so much research for finding out, you know, did the waitress bring the appetizer fast enough or was the food a little spicy? And they don't settle for any less than, you know, 4.8 stars for the little stuff. But no one's asking themselves the bigger question is, where would my bank rate? Not, you know, where does my local Chase Bank or my local ANZ branch, where do they rank, you know, locally? And again, you know, Tina gave bad customer service. But where does my bank rate on a global level? Is my bank good enough? Or are there banks somewhere else? I remember talking during the global recession about how banks in the United States and the UK were in the 40s in terms of best countries to bank. Where does your citizenship rank? If you were to give your citizenship a star rating, where does it rank? Does your country impose high taxes on you? Do they impose a lot of restrictions? Do they make you fill out a lot of forms? Do they restrict you from doing business? Do they limit your income potential? Does the place you live tax 30 or 40 or 50% of your income, right? What is the star rating for everything that you're doing on a macro level? The institutions that you work with on a global level, where would they rate? Because I can tell you, I grew up in the United States. I can tell you the banks that I bank in now are a 5-star. They're a 4.8 star. The service is better. They're stronger. One of my banks is in the top 10 strongest banks on planet Earth, okay? No bank in the United States even comes close to that ranking. And so we're so fascinated about, you know, what's the ranking on our street tacos? What's the ranking on the pizza place? And when we have a bad experience, we're so quick to go on and, oh, yeah, let me, you know, 3 stars. They could have improved the pepperoni. Why aren't we questioning the very places that we're from? Why aren't we questioning the things in our life that we take for granted, which is our money, our freedom, our ability to grow wealth? I bet if you really examined your life in that area, you'd find a lot of 2.1 star institutions that need to be replaced. If you wouldn't go to a pizza place with 2.1 stars, you shouldn't settle for banking infrastructure or citizenship or investment opportunities or anything else that's at the same star level. Always demand 5-star. Demand to go where you're treated best. Hi, I'm Andrew Henderson from Nomad Capitalist. I wrote this book, which you can find on Amazon, to distill a lot of the stuff we talk about in these videos and a lot of the stuff I've learned over the last decade plus traveling all around the world, teaching you about how to legally reduce your taxes, build your personal freedom, and create wealth faster. Definitely get a copy of this book if you want to learn more. Now, if you want to watch more videos, make sure you subscribe to our channel and make sure you click the notifications bell so you never miss one of our new videos with more tips on how to go where you're treated best. And if you're already a 6- or 7-figure entrepreneur and you'd like to put these strategies in place for yourself, go to nomadcapitalist.com and learn about how I can help you.